Okay, let's move on to syncope. That's fainting. That's a sudden temporary loss of consciousness and muscle tone.
From low blood flow to the brain.
Right, and then you recover on your own.
Spontaneous recovery, that's key.
Yeah. And you divide the causes into two main categories, right? Heart-related and non-heart-related.
Cardiogenic and non-cardiogenic.
Right, okay. What are some examples of each of those?
So heart-related syncope, that could be arrhythmias, those irregular heartbeats,
mm-hmm.
or blockages like a pulmonary embolism or pulmonary hypertension,
right?
A heart attack, MI, or problems with the heart valves.
Okay.
Non-heart-related causes, those are more varied, things like low blood volume, hypovolemia,
mm-hmm.
or the vasovagal reflex. That's when your heart rate and blood pressure drop suddenly, often triggered by stress or standing up for too long.
Oh, okay.
Orthostatic hypotension, that's low blood pressure when you stand up. Even some brain stuff, like a stroke or a seizure. And metabolic causes, like low blood sugar.
Wow, so many different things. So when someone faints, getting a good history is super important.
Absolutely.
What are the key questions?
Well, first, were there any warning signs, any prodrome?
Okay.
Like dizziness, nausea, sweating. What were they doing when they fainted?
Yeah.
Standing for a long time, exercising.
Yeah.
Did it happen after a sudden pain? And then what happened after they regained consciousness?
Okay.
Were they confused? Did they hurt themselves? How long did it take to feel normal again?
And how can you tell the difference between syncope and a seizure? That seems tricky.
It can be. But with syncope, they usually recover faster and they're not confused afterwards.
Okay.
Although they might have some brief muscle twitches, myoclonic jerks. But with seizures, there's often a postictal state. That's a period of confusion and disorientation. And they might bite their tongue, which is more common with seizures.
When should you be thinking that fainting might be caused by a heart problem?
Well, there are a few red flags. Like if it happened very suddenly, no warning signs.
Okay.
Or they had chest pain or palpitations where they felt their heart racing or skipping beats. Or if they have a history of heart disease.